Could it be that time, as we know it, has no true beginning? Is it possible that the universe existed before the Big Bang? Only a short while ago, these questions would have been dismissed as heresy. Yet, the rise of string theory and theoretical physics has opened up a new frontier in cosmology, inviting us to explore the universe before the Big Bang. Tracing back through the annals of time, we find this question of the universe's origins has been a point of contention for centuries. The ancient Greeks, for instance, were divided on the matter. Aristotle, a proponent of the eternal universe theory, argued that nothing comes from nothing. Therefore, the universe must have always existed, with time stretching infinitely into the past and future. Christian theologians, however, presented a contrasting view. Augustine proposed that God, existing outside of space and time, could create these constructs from nothing. To the question, what was God doing before he created the world? Augustine simply replied, time itself being part of God's creation, there was simply no before. Fast forward to the 20th century, and we find Albert Einstein's general theory of relativity echoing this sentiment. His theory, confirming that space and time are malleable, led to the realization that our universe is expanding, with distant galaxies moving apart from one another. Following this line of thought, physicists Stephen W. Hawking and Roger Penrose concluded that time cannot extend back indefinitely. As we rewind the cosmic history, all galaxies converge to a single infinitesimal point, known as a singularity. Here, density, temperature, and space-time curvature become infinite, marking a cataclysmic point beyond which our cosmic ancestry cannot extend. From the ancient Greeks to Augustine, from Einstein to Hawking and Penrose, the journey of understanding the universe's origins has been a fascinating one. Yet, string theory suggests that perhaps the Big Bang was not the beginning, but merely a transition from a pre-existing state. This new perspective has us questioning everything we thought we knew about the origin of the universe. So, was the Big Bang really the beginning of time? Or was it a gateway from an older universe to ours? These are the questions that continue to drive our quest for understanding. As we delve deeper into the cosmic past, we may yet discover that our universe's roots extend far beyond the boundaries we once thought were absolute. And in doing so, we continue to grapple with the grand set of concerns. Where do we come from? What are we? And where are we going? Strange coincidence. Nevertheless, the properties of the Milky Way are basically the same as those of distant galaxies. It is as though you showed up at a party only to find you were wearing exactly the same clothes as a dozen of your closest friends. If just two of you were dressed the same, it might be explained away as coincidence, but a dozen suggests that the partygoers had coordinated their attire in advance. In cosmology, the number is not a dozen, but tens of thousands, the number of independent, yet statistically identical patches of sky in the microwave background. One possibility is that all those regions of space were endowed at birth with identical properties. In other words, that the homogeneity is mere coincidence. Physicists, however, have thought about two more natural ways out of the impasse. The early universe was much smaller or much older than in standard cosmology. Either or both acting together would have made intercommunication possible. The most popular choice follows the first alternative. It postulates that the universe went through a period of accelerating expansion, known as inflation, early in its history. Before this phase, galaxies or their precursors were so closely packed that they could easily coordinate their properties. During inflation, they fell out of contact because light was unable to keep pace with the frenetic expansion. After inflation ended, the expansion began to decelerate, so galaxies gradually came back into one another's view. Physicists ascribe the inflationary spurt to the potential energy stored in a new quantum field, the inflaton, about 1035 seconds after the Big Bang. Potential energy, as opposed to rest mass or kinetic energy, leads to gravitational repulsion. Rather than slowing down the expansion, as the gravitation of ordinary matter would, the inflaton accelerated it. Proposed in 1981, inflation has explained a wide variety of observations with precision. See The Inflationary Universe by Alan H. Guth and Paul J. Steinhardt, Scientific American, May 1984, and Four Keys to Cosmology, Special Report, Scientific American, February 2004. A number of possible theoretical problems remain, though, beginning with the questions of what exactly the inflaton was and what gave it such a huge initial potential energy. A less widely known way to solve the puzzle follows the second alternative by getting rid of the singularity. If time did not begin at the bang, if a long era preceded the onset of the present cosmic expansion, matter could have had plenty of time to arrange itself smoothly. Therefore, researchers have re-examined the reasoning that led them to infer a singularity. One of the assumptions that relativity theory is always valid is questionable. Close to the putative singularity, quantum effects must have been important, even dominant. Standard relativity takes no account of such effects, so accepting the inevitability of the singularity amounts to trusting the theory beyond reason. To know what really happened, physicists need to subsume relativity in a quantum theory of gravity. The task has occupied theorists from Einstein onward, but progress was almost zero until the mid-1980s.